Hi all, today we can discuss about a diffraction due to end slits, that is diffraction grating. Diffraction grating is an arrangement of a large number of slits. In the last videos we have seen diffraction at a single slit and diffraction due to double slit. Here we are considering so many slits. These slits are of equal weight and these slits are separated by some opaque portions. These opaque portions are also of equal width. Then such an arrangement is called diffraction grating. That is, diffraction grating means it is an arrangement consisting of a large number of equally spaced parallel slits of equal width. They are separated from each other by opaque spaces which are also of equal width. So here this is a diffraction grating. Here we have so many slits. Each slit is having a width A and the opaque portion in between the slit is having width B. How can we make a grating? The grating can be produced by making ruled lines on an optically plain glass plate. The scale with you is an example for a grating. Here you have 10 lines in 1 centimeter. If we wanted to make 100 lines in 1 centimeter, that is difficult. So, with the help of diamond point on a plain glass plate, fine equidistant parallel rule lines are making. These lines will be opaque to the light, whereas the space between these ruled lines will act as slits. The diffraction grating that we are using in the laboratory is having 15,000 lines per inch. So to make 15,000 lines in 1 inch is difficult. So due to this technical difficulties, for practical purpose, duplicate gratings are made. So this replica of grating can be made by pouring some collodion solution over the original grating. Then the evaporation of these solution will produce to a thin film. So this thin film can stripe off from the surface of original grating. So that film will have the print of that original grating. Then this film is placed between two plain glass plates and that arrangement we are using as a diffraction grating for practical purposes. Now we can analyze the theory of diffraction due to grating. Here A is the width of each slit and B is the width of opaque portion. So this A plus B that we can denote as D, the sum of this width of slit and opaque portion is known as grating element. That is, grating element D is equal to A plus B. If we take the reciprocal of this grating element, that gives number of ruled lines per unit width of grating. Let there are n ruled lines in 1 centimeter. Then this 1 centimeter is equal to n into the distance between two ruled lines, that is equal to A plus B. So n into A plus B is 1 centimeter. So the reciprocal of this A plus B, that is grating element, will be n per centimeter. That is the number of ruled lines per unit length and the grating element are reciprocal to each other. Let a plain wavefront of wavelength lambda is incident on this diffraction grating arrangement. Then each point on the incident wavefront in the plane of the slit will act as a source of secondary wavelet. These secondary wavelets, which are moving in the same direction as that of the incident wavefront, will focus at the center point and that will produce a center bright image. And the wavelets which are diffracted at an angle theta, they are focusing at another point Q. So at the point Q, it is bright or dark, that depends upon the path difference. And in the double slit experiment, we are seeing the path difference is equal to, here the grating element is A plus B, so that is A plus B sine theta. And similarly, the phase difference phi is equal to 2 pi by lambda into A plus B sine theta, because phase difference is equal to path difference into 2 pi by lambda. Now, what will be the resultant intensity? For that, we have to find the resultant amplitude. So using the vector addition method, the resultant amplitude R is equal to A sin alpha by alpha into sin n gamma by sin gamma, where alpha is equal to pi A sin theta by lambda, gamma is equal to pi D sin theta by lambda. A is the width of each slit and D is equal to A plus B, that is sum of width of slit and opaque portion. Now, the resultant intensity will be the square of this amplitude, that is I is equal to A square sin square alpha by alpha square into sin square n gamma by sin square gamma, where this A square sin square alpha by alpha square is due to diffraction at each single slit, and sin square n gamma by sin square gamma gives interference due to diffracted waves from n slits. So the final diffraction pattern will be the resultant of the diffraction due to single slit and the interference due to diffracted waves from n slits, where this A square we can write as I0. So the resultant intensity expression is I0 sin square alpha by alpha square into sin square n gamma by sin square gamma, where alpha is pi A sin theta by lambda and gamma is pi D sin theta by lambda, where D is the grating element. Now we can see the conditions for principal maximum and minimum based on this intensity expression. The condition for principal maxima in the diffraction pattern due to grating, we can find out from this intensity expression. For principal maxima, the intensity must be maximum. Here the intensity is proportional to sin square n gamma by sin square gamma, that is the effect due to the interference of wavelets from n slits. Then the sin square alpha by alpha square we have seen in the single slit discussion. So here the intensity is maximum for the principal maxima. For the intensity to be maximum, the denominator must be minimum. So that for that sin square gamma must be 0 or sin gamma must be 0. If the denominator sin gamma is equal to 0, the gamma must be and multiple of pi, that is gamma is equal to plus or minus m pi. Sin 0, sin pi, sin 2 pi, sin 3 pi, etc. are 0. So gamma is equal to plus or minus m pi. What is the value of gamma? That is pi d sin theta by lambda. So we can substitute the value of gamma here. Pi d sin theta by lambda is equal to plus or minus m pi. So pi and pi will cancel and we will get d sin theta is equal to plus or minus m lambda. This is the condition for principal maximum in grating, and this equation is known as grating equation, where D is the grating element, that is A plus B. So A plus B sin theta is equal to plus or minus M lambda, where M is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. If M is equal to 0, that will correspond to theta is equal to 0 degree. That is, all the secondary wavelets which are moving in the same direction as that of the incident wavelet, that are focusing at the center and that corresponding to the center maximum, where this center maximum is known as 0th order principal maximum. Now, if M is equal to 1, then it is known as first order principal maximum. When M is equal to 2, it is called second order principal maximum, etc. Then what will be the expression for the intensity for this principal maximum? For that, this intensity expression I is equal to I0 sin square alpha by alpha square into sin square n gamma by sin square gamma, where this gamma tends to plus or minus m pi. That is, limit gamma tends to plus or minus m pi. Now we can apply the L'Hospital rule here. What is L'Hospital rule? Limit gamma tends to plus or minus m pi sine n gamma by sine gamma is equal to n. Then I is equal to I zero sine square alpha by alpha square into limit gamma tends to plus or minus m pi sine square n gamma by sine square gamma will be n square, because sine n gamma by sine gamma with the limit gamma tends to plus or minus m pi is n. If we are considering sine square n gamma by sine square gamma, that will be n square. So this is the resultant intensity expression for principal maxima in diffraction grating, that is I is directly proportional to n square. As the number of slits increases, intensity of principal maxima increases. In the double slit discussion, we have seen that in the intensity there was a 4. That 4 comes from the 2 slits, that is 2 square will lead to 4. So if we have n slit, the final intensity will be n square times the intensity due to the individual slit. Now we can find the condition for minima. For the minima condition, this intensity must be minimum. For the intensity to be minimum, here the sine square n gamma, that is the numerator term, goes to 0. So that is sine square n gamma is equal to 0. If sine square n gamma is equal to 0, sine n gamma is equal to 0, then this n gamma must be a multiple of pi, that is n gamma equal to plus or minus m pi, or gamma is equal to plus or minus m pi by n, where we can substitute the value of gamma. What is value of gamma? Pi d sine theta by lambda is equal to plus or minus m pi by n, or pi and pi will cancel and we will get d sine theta is equal to plus or minus m lambda by n. So this is the condition for minimum, that is d sine theta is equal to plus or minus m lambda by n. Now what are the possible values for this m? Is it possible that m is equal to 0? No. Because if m equal to 0, that corresponding to principal maximum of 0th order, that is center maximum. Is it possible that m is equal to n? If m equal to n, what happens here? D sine theta is equal to plus or minus lambda. That is the condition for the first order principal maximum. If m is equal to 2n, then this equation becomes d sine theta is equal to plus or minus 2 lambda. That is the condition for second order principal maximum. So m cannot have the values 0n, 2n, 3n, etc. Because 0 corresponding to principal maximum of 0th order, then n, 2n, 3n, etc. corresponding to the principal maximum of first order, second order, third order, etc. Then what are the values of m possible here? M can have values from 0 to n minus 1. N is not possible. Then after n, again n plus 1, n plus 2, etc. up to 2n minus 1. Thus, between the 0th order principal maximum and first order principal maximum, there will be n minus 1 minima, because 1, 2, 3, etc. up to n minus 1 minima will be there. And between this first order and the second order principal maximum, again there will be n minus 1 minima. So this is the intensity pattern due to diffraction grating. The first figure corresponds to the diffraction at each individual slit. That is a variation of sine square alpha by alpha square. The second one corresponds to the interference of wavelets which are coming from n slits. So this is 0th order principal maximum. This is first order principal maximum. So between the 0th order and first order principal maximum, there will be n minus 1 minima. Between two such a consecutive minimum, there is a maximum. These maxima are called secondary maximum. That is, in between 0th order and first order principal maximum, there will be n minus 1 minima and there will be n minus 2 secondary maxima. But these secondary maxima are of very small intensity. And the resultant of the diffraction due to each individual slit and the interference of wavelets from n slits will give the final pattern. This, that is, the envelope of this single slit diffraction is coming over the n slit interference pattern, and the final intensity pattern will be like this. What is the maximum number of orders possible in diffraction due to grating? What is the grating equation? D sin theta is equal to m lambda. That is, m is equal to d sin theta divided by lambda. So for the m to be maximum, the sin theta value must be maximum. So the maximum value of sin theta is 1. So the maximum order possible is d divided by lambda. That is, d is a plus b. So maximum order is a plus b divided by lambda. If a plus b is less than lambda, that is, grating element is less than lambda, this maximum order will be less than 1. Then in the grating spectrum, only we will get the zeroth order principal maximum. If this a plus b is less than 2 lambda, then this m maximum will be less than 2. Then in the grating spectrum, we have zeroth order principal maximum and first order principal maximum. So that's all about the theory of diffraction grating. One of the main application of grating is we can find out the wavelength of light accurately using the grating. We can find out the wavelength of light using diffraction grating with the help of a spectrometer. For that, we are keeping the grating on the prism table of the spectrometer. Then the light is made to incident normally on this grating. Then we can view the light which are passing through the grating using the telescope. If we view the light using the telescope in the straight line direction, that is in the same direction as that of the incident ray, we will get to the zeroth order principal maximum. Then rotating the telescope to the one side, we will get to the first order principal maximum. If we rotate again, we can see the second order principal maximum, etc. Similarly, on rotating to the other side, we can also view first order, second order, principal maximum. From the vernier table of the telescope, we can take the reading for this first order on left and right side. Then the difference will give the 2 theta for m is equal to 1. Then we can use the grating equation d sin theta is equal to m lambda. For from that equation, we can find out the wavelength of light as d sin theta divided by m, where d is the grating element, that is the reciprocal of number of lines per centimeter. Theta we are getting from this 2 theta values, m corresponding to 1 here. Again, if you are taking the reading for the second order grating spectrum from left side and right side, we also get the 2 theta for m is equal to 2. Again, if we substitute m equal to 2 here and theta values, then we will get the lambda and we can find out the wavelength of light. If we are using monochromatic source of light, our zeroth order, first order, second order light will be having only one wavelength. If we are replacing this monochromatic source of light with white light, how the grating spectrum will look? Then also we will get to this zeroth order, first order, second order, etc. But the zeroth order is the light which are traveling in the same direction as that of the incident ray. That will look white. But here the first order and second order principal maximum will have 7 colors. That is, this first order principal maximum will have violet to red. And also the second order principal maximum will have colors violet to red. So the spectrum for the first order will have 7 colors. Again, the second order principal maximum will have 7 colors. So using grating, we can find out the wavelength of light with the help of the expression d sin theta is equal to m lambda. So the numericals based on the diffraction grating, we can do in the next video.